This review was prepared by Roba Abbas and Katina Michael and published by TheoryHub. TheoryHub covers a wide range of theories and acts as a starting point for theory exploration in different research and teaching and learning contexts. This is a review of the socio-technical theory. Socio-technical theory is an organizational theory that conceptualizes a given work or other system in view of its constituent social and technical subsystems, with the goal of achieving system success through joint optimization. Socio-technical theory originated in the 1950s at the Tavistock Institute in London, led by Tristan Bamforth and Emery. It resulted from industry-based action research focusing on coal mining and labour studies in Britain. Built on an open systems foundation, the theory promised a new paradigm that defied the dominant technological imperative at the time, in favour of an approach that perceived people as more than extensions to machines. The proposed socio-technical paradigm also deviated from the notion that people were dispensable to a perspective where individuals were considered as a resource to be developed, encouraging collaboration, commitment, and a risk-taking environment, as opposed to competition, alienation, and minimal levels of risk-taking, respectively. The socio-technical approach is a method of viewing organizations which emphasizes the interrelatedness of the functioning of the social and technological subsystems of the organization and the relation of the organization as a whole to the environment in which it operates. Put simply, the socio-technical system perspective contends that organizations are made up of people that produce products or services using some technology, and that each affects the operation and appropriateness of the technology as well as the actions of the people who operate it. Within this definition is the value-added notion, whereby the products and services produced are valued by customers. Further simplified, Emery maintains that socio-technical research is about mutual benefits derived from the intersection of social and technical elements. This intersection emphasizes a reciprocity between humans and machines, in which a process of dual shaping of the social and technical systems occurs. As such, the socio-technical approach defines the social and technical dimensions, which are termed subsystems, that form a system of interest or broader system, known as a suprasystem. The theory stipulates that the success of the socio-technical system is a product of the interactions between these subsystems. Socio-technical theory emerged in response to dominant technocratic models that were technologically deterministic, ignoring human factors. These models were regarded as restrictive in their disregard for the social aspects within a system, particularly with respect to how the social subsystem interacts with the technical subsystem. As such, the socio-technical approach was proposed to acknowledge the significance of society or the social aspects in the design, redesign, and interventions affecting a system. The aim of each subsystem would be to meet its own objectives by using its own means, but is also in an interdependent relation with other subsystems. Design activities were originally completed in the context of a primary work system or organizational unit as the main units of analysis. Alternate units of analysis were also recognized in early socio-technical studies, external to the primary work system or the organizational boundary, acknowledging the macrosocial as a significant unit of analysis. Support for socio-technical theory was initially underwhelming, and it was not till the 1980s that a shift from the dominant technocratic and bureaucratic mode became apparent. This transition was encouraged in seminal work concerning social analyses in the technology realm, which maintained that deviance from the technical determinist orientation was necessary in researching technologies. Socio-technical theory is built on the foundations of general systems theory and open systems theory. An open system, as opposed to a closed system, can be defined as one in which there is flow and/or interaction between components and the environment, resulting in the modification or evolution of system components. Consequently, socio-technical systems inherit key assumptions, concepts, and characteristics from these parent theories. These inherited elements include concepts relevant to responsiveness to environmental factors and the key notion of equifinality in the achievement of a steady state. With respect to the environment, the open systems perspective acknowledges that a system's success and/or survival is affected by the way it interacts with its environment, and its evolution and responsiveness to any changing conditions. This implies that environmental factors will influence the way the system behaves, and therefore, to resolve complex issues, the dynamics between psychological, economic, technical, cultural, and political aspects need to be understood. The socio-technical approach distinguishes between various dimensions of a given system through the concept of a subsystem. Initial studies identified the dimensions of a socio-technical system as socio-psychological, referencing the people and denoting the human aspects, the technological, as referring to the artifacts or the things, and the economic, as representing the effectiveness of interactions between the human and technological resources. Current conceptualizations are concerned with three primary dimensions or subsystems, which are the social, technical, and environmental. In a general sense, the social subsystem refers to the human factors or elements present in a socio-technical system. In an organizational setting, the social subsystem comprises the individuals or people that constitute an organization and the relationships, values, structure, work-related elements and associations that are delivered by organizational members. The technical subsystem refers to the physical and material flows within a transformation process, in addition to the tasks, control and maintenance functions, and when applied to the organizational setting, denotes the tools, techniques, skills, and devices that are required by workers to fulfill organizational objectives and tasks. These subsystems collectively operate within a given environmental subsystem, which influences their function and the way in which they interact. The environmental subsystem is defined as the context, surroundings, and conditions within which the open socio-technical system operates and is situated, referring to both the internal and external environment. According to the founders of the socio-technical school of thought, and in the context of the coal mining industry, the interactions between the social, technical, and environmental systems are conveyed as follows. So close is the relationship between the various aspects that the social and the psychological can be understood only in terms of the detailed engineering facts and of the way the technological system as a whole behaves in the environment of the underground situation. Socio-technical perspectives of an organization or work system are similarly comprised of distinct but interrelated social and technical subsystems, where a work system is a primary unit or department within an organization that can be regarded and designed as a socio-technical system consisting of interacting subsystems, within which subdimensions exist. There are two main principles of socio-technical theory, the first relating to the nature of interactions between the social and technical components in defining the degree of success of a system, and the second concerning the goodness of fit between the social and technical factors of an organization, which results in an optimum state for the suprasystem. This fit was formally termed joint optimization, which fundamentally refers to equal consideration of the technical and human elements throughout the socio-technical design or redesign process. It entails achieving a best match between the requirements of the social and technical systems. The principles of the theory, specifically the principle of joint optimization, are operationalized through a process of socio-technical design, redesign, or some other form of socio-technical intervention, depending on the unit of analysis in each project. Socio-technical design signifies the design or redesign of systems achieved through stakeholder participation and incorporating interaction between people and technologies. From a theoretical and philosophical perspective, the socio-technical approach was promising in its deviation from technological determinism and its emphasis on joint optimization of the social and technical subsystems. Ideally, the socio-technical approach leads to mutually beneficial outcomes. However, according to critics, the theory initially failed to live up to its potential. For instance, an analysis of applicability showed that there are inherent flaws within socio-technical theory, one of which is related to the joint optimization notion. The question was raised whether earlier and founding socio-technical studies did in fact achieve jointly optimized socio-technical systems, claiming that activities privileged the social system. It was explained that optimization was not a product of finding a suitable match between the social and technical subsystems, but rather with independently adapting the social subsystem to support technology. With respect to socio-technical design, further weaknesses have been exposed using a critical information systems lens. While stakeholder participation and consultation are regarded as critical to socio-technical design success and the achievement of joint optimization, participation can also have an undesirable effect in cases where consensus cannot be achieved. This may result in an inability to reconcile competing and divergent stakeholder interests and an intensification of the gap between stakeholders and their varying interests. Thank you for listening. To download the full review or to read other theory reviews, visit open.ncl.ac.uk.